Hello students, I hope you all are well along with your family members under these conditions. Children, before starting the video lecture of today's class, I would like to discuss couple of things with you. I hope and strongly believe that things are settled in your life by now and you are mentally prepared that you will be taking part actively as far as online teaching is concerned, online classes they are concerned. Children, when I was speaking to so many teachers associated with 12th science especially. So they have told me, or I came to know, that few of you are not responding well. Children, we are using our energy because of you only. It is all for the benefit of yours. So I hope you all will be cooperating as far as these online classes they are concerned. You will be watching these videos carefully. You will prepare your notes. You will be doing the assignments. And you will be giving your feedback from time to your teachers. Right? Thank you so much. Now I will start the proceedings of this video. Children, I will start today's class, today's lecture, by a concept, important concept called the power of a lens. Children, the power of a lens represented by P, by the definition it is defined as the reciprocal of focal length. Reciprocal means 1 upon focal length. So P is equal to 1 upon F. F stands for the focal length of the lens, whether it is convex lens or a concave lens. Children, now what must be the SI units for the power of the lens? Remember children, if you take focal length in meters, then the SI unit for the power of the lens, it will become diopter, D-I-O-P-T-R-E. In short, we write it as D, capital D, the diopter. Alright, so remember, P is equal to 1 upon F, D means diopter. Alright, this is the formula for the power of a lens. Now children, before moving ahead, we'll tell you some things which are very important for the point of view of numerical problems. Children, as per new sign conventions, you have got, see the board, we have got two types of lenses. The one is called convex lens, the other one is called concave lens. Children, when you solve a numerical problem, in some numerical you will be taking focal length to be plus, in some numerical it will be taken as minus. Where it will be plus, where it will be minus, all depends upon our new sign conventions. So always remember children, like we have already done in the topic called reflection, the distance of object is always minus or taken negative in both the cases. Remember forever. Whether convex lens or concave lens, u is always minus. Next, focal length. The focal length of a convex lens or converging lens is always positive. Power of a convex lens is always positive. Reason being, because power is 1 upon focal length. So power wholly and solely depends upon the focal length. So whatever is the sign of focal length, same will be the sign for the power. Alright? Here, if you see for concave lens, the focal length is taken to be minus as well as the power of the lens is taken to be minus. Alright? So these three points are really important from the point of view of your numericals. Children, next thing, what happens if you are given combination of lenses? Maybe, for example, see here, if for the sake of simplicity I consider two lenses, say this is lens number 1, this is lens number 2. I am keeping these two convex lenses in contact with each other. The focal length of this lens is f1, second lens f2, the power of first lens let it be p1, the power of second lens let it be p2, its magnification is m1, and the magnification here let it be m2. Children, need not to tell you that this combination will start behaving like a single convex lens, single lens I must say. Let the focal length of the single lens be f, the power be p, and the magnification total let it be capital, I mean n, only n. So children, the simple formulae you are supposed to learn, they are also important from the point of view of numericals. Remember, P will be equal to P1 plus P2. This is formula number 1. Now, what happens, as you know, because power is 1 upon focal length, so 1 upon F will be equal to 1 upon F1 plus 1 upon F2. This becomes second formula. And children, as far as the magnification is concerned, the last we shall be having M1 into M2. This is number 3. One more thing I would like to mention here, as far as the simple proof is concerned, I shall be giving you, supplying you the proof in form of the notes. Alright? Okay. Now let us move towards another important topic of this pre-optics and optical instruments. We will start optical instruments. Alright? As it is already written over here, our new topic will be optical instruments. Children, one simple question I am asking. What is the most common optical instruments among all optical instruments we have seen in our life so far? The answer is, I am asking this question because you have already done the same topic in 10th standard. The answer is human eye. Children, the first optical instrument all of us we have been using, okay, is just human eye. And I need not to tell you, you know very well, the human eye we have got main part is convex lens. This is convex lens of flexible focal length and flexible power. As per our requirement, we are able to change its power as well as the focal length. That is called the power of accommodation. This is done with the help of ciliary muscles and all. Alright? Children, before going ahead, some concepts, basic concepts I shall be using, so it is better if we discuss now. The concept number one is, what happens as far as the human eye is concerned? Remember, this is the fact of human eye I am telling you. If you keep an object at a distance of 25 centimeters from human eye, this distance is represented by capital D, 25 centimeters. Children, most comfortably, without putting our eye into the screen, we are able to see that thing. This small d is called near point for the normal human eye, or it is also called minimum or least distant of distinct vision. So this concept is going to be used in optical instruments. Alright, I hope you will be able to learn it forever. Whenever you see capital D in the upcoming formulae, capital D stands for 25 centimeters, and it is taken as the minimum or the shortest distance or the least distance for human eye, or the minimum distance of distinct vision. Alright, now let us come to concept number 2. The concept number 2 is called angular magnification. Children, I give one example. If I have two points, point number 1 and point number 2, if you are here, so this angle is basically called theta, let it be theta. This angle is called the angular limit of resolution. Children, if you increase this distance, if you are here, the angle will become small. If you are here, further it will become small. So you know very well what I am talking about. You will be able to see these two points separately from each other up to some limit. That limit is basically called angular limit of resolution, and it is represented by what is called theta. Alright, a simple concept. Now let me just come to what is called another important concept, resolving power. R-E-S-O-L, resolving power. Resolving power means power to resolve. If I have quoted this example, these two points are separated from each other up to some limit. After that limit, your eye or human eye cannot discriminate. All right? So children, the resolving power, which is true for any optical instrument, we are going to discuss after short while from now. Resolving power, whether it is a microscope or a telescope, is basically equal to 1 upon theta. What is theta? Already told you, theta is angular limit of resolution. So resolving power, the reciprocal of theta is called resolving power. And remember, theta is equal to 1.22 lambda divided by d. So when you substitute the value of theta in this formula, d will come up, 1.22 lambda will come down. So we shall have the resolving power will become equal to d upon 1.22 into lambda. So children, I ask two simple questions which are important from the point of view of your board's examination. What is capital D, what is lambda, and how the resolving power depends upon these two parameters? Answer is, children, D stands for diameter of lens. This is an important point I would like to make here. D is not the minimum distance of distant vision, that is 25 centimeters, as I told you a short while before now, right? Here D stands for diameter of the lens. For example, if you are watching anything with the help of your eye, then the diameter of eye lens is called, you know, capital D, the big D. Next thing is called lambda, the wavelength of light. Alright, now I must answer two simple questions. What are the two factors on which the resolving power depends? Number one, the resolving power is directly proportional to the diameter. And number two, resolving power is inversely proportional to lambda. It is concept number two. Remember. So you must prepare mentally yourself that questions may be one marker. If you increase the diameter, what happens to the resolving power? It will increase. If you decrease the diameter, it will decrease, and vice versa. Similarly, see here, the resolving power is inversely proportional to lambda. Depends upon the wavelength of the light. So if red light is replaced by blue light, okay, then what would happen to the resolving power? So you must prepare yourself mentally for these types of questions. They will be frequently asked in your board's examinations and all. Alright, children, I think this is enough for this video. We shall be switching into another topic called microscopes and telescopes in our next video. Thank you for watching. God bless you. All the best.